even while living out your dream, traveling the world, bad things can happen. And if they do, just don't give up. I had a serious injury while traveling, which required me to have surgery. This is my story. I hope it gives you inspiration to not give up yourself.
You, me, or nobody is gonna hit as hard as life. But it ain't about how hard you hit. It's about how hard you can get hit and keep moving forward. How much you can take and keep moving forward. That's how winning is done.
Well, it's always darkest before the dawn, and that's exactly what happened here. I was in the best shape of my life before I fell from heights with an extended hand and messed up my wrist. I actually didn't even think it was broken at first. I thought I sprained it, so stubborn Jay went ahead and kept traveling for 2.5 weeks without even going to the hospital. Whew, what a genius, right? Well, it wasn't until 2.5 weeks after that I met a nurse who said, "This has been 2.5 weeks, get your butt to the hospital." So that's exactly what I did. I went to the hospital and it was a joke. The surgeon put me in a cast. He didn't even recommend surgery right away, which, knowing what I know now, I should have had surgery right then. But I didn't. So they put me in a cast, and he didn't even put me in the right cast. He didn't immobilize the thumb. Bad, bad surgeon. So I then had this cast on for 4 weeks, was recommended to get another x-ray, see if it was healed. I was in Myanmar at the time. Oh, no. If you're in Myanmar and you need medical care, do not be a dumbass like this guy. Get out of Myanmar, go to a place with proper health care. What a joke. That place was insane. Hundreds of people surrounding the hospital. All open air hospital. Everyone using the same bed. No hygiene. People with the worst open sores I've ever seen. There was one guy wheeled by me. I kid you not, he probably lost his leg. It was so infected. It was just sad. Very sad. And then it came time for them to remove the old cast and put a new one on. So here comes this little nurse wearing one of those nursing caps from the 1900s out with this saw that looked like it was older than I was, covered in rust, scared the shit out of me. So here she is, starts to cut on my wrist where the cast was. I thought she was gonna cut my hand for sure. I was petrified. I shit myself. Yeah, I did. It was crazy, but she did an excellent job and I got another cast on. I will say, guys, do not take your health care for granted, because wow, this was sad. I would not want to be reliant on this health care. Whew. So fast forward, now it has been 3 months since I injured my hand and it has not healed. I got another x-ray, the fracture is still there. I'm in Indonesia, beautiful place, but again, not the best healthcare. So I'm like, right, okay, healthcare, fine. If I go back to the States, I know what's gonna happen. This trip is over. I have sacrificed too much for this. This is my freaking dream. I'm not giving up on it. Let's find a place over here in Asia. So, did my research. I had really 3 options. So, in Asia was Singapore, Thailand, and Malaysia. Malaysia has excellent health care. A lot of their doctors were trained in the U.S., and the doctor that I had was. I mean, he was amazing. Dr. Ranjit Singhal. I loved him. Excellent. I can't tell you enough. I had the surgery with him. I was scared. I'm not gonna lie, I was scared. I had no one to help me. My family's all over in the States. Lucy Fisher, thank God her soul, she is such a wonderful person, stayed by my side during this time, and I really can't thank her enough. I really can't. It was insane. So I had surgery. I had slight avascular necrosis, which means as part of the bone had died because of the way this bone is that I broke. It only gets blood supply from one end, so when you break it completely in half like I did, the bottom half cannot get any blood supply and therefore actually die. When this happens, guess what? A dead bone can't heal. So you need to promote new growth. So they need to take a piece of bone from your freaking hip and put it into your wrist. And that's exactly what happened for me. So they take a piece of bone out of my hip, put it in my wrist, put screw through it to keep it together, and there you go. Hope it heals. Fingers crossed. So I also had this patch of fat on my hip that got caught there from my belt buckle, and the doctor removed it. Now I'm less body fat. Woohoo! Now if you think this is a sad story, you're in the wrong place. I have been traveling around ever since this injury. It did not stop me. Doctors told me to go home. No! Hell no! Family, friends, and everyone else on Facebook and Instagram, I just wanted to send you a big hello, lots of love. I hope you're doing well, and if you're not doing well, keep moving forward and it will get better. I promise you it will get better. Just don't give up. But most importantly, don't forget to smile.
I love you guys.
Thank you.